is so attracted to her hat.
Welcome to closing ceremonies of Daisho Con 2016. I am Missy Brightside. I'm one of the co-directors of the con this year.
Thank you. My name is Olivia Offenbacher, and I am the other co-director of Daisho Con 2016.
2016?
We made it through another one. Do we have any first-time condors in here? Welcome! And you stayed all the way to the end.
Congratulations.
Congratulations. So welcome to closing ceremonies. We're just going to talk a little bit about what we did this year, and then we're going to open it up for questions if anybody has any questions about how we ran things, or if you want to comment on some stuff, we'll take those. So this year we did a lot of awesome new things, and I hope you enjoyed all of them. One of them being on Thursday night, for those congoers who showed up Thursday night. Oh, we have a lot of congoers who check in Thursday night to get ready for the weekend. You did?
Yeah!
We opened up Thursday night registration, so you all could get your badges if you pre-registered. And we offered a midnight release showing of Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them with people who had badges to get in at the AMC Theater, which is attached to the Kalahari. We worked really hard to make that happen for all your condors. I know probably some of you have heard me say that before, and we're really glad that we got to offer that to you. And I hope that some of you made it and you enjoyed it. We also partnered with the AMC Theater on Saturday to show a showing of Boy and the Beast in the theater for folks who had badges. We gave away seats to all of you. So, they're just talking. Okay, cool. We did a lot of all their awesome things. So those of you who got tired of carrying around our big thick guidebooks all year or all weekend, some of you might carry them around all year. I don't, but we created this awesome fold-out short version for the people with tiny pockets. All the ladies are like, yeah, I have tiny pockets. With our schedule on the front, map on the back. Did you all like that?
Yeah.
All right, we'll try to bring that back.
I did. Awesome.
We had a Nerf arena.
Yeah. Who has the Nerf arena?
Not bad. What?
They're all too tired. They're all too tired and probably went home, maybe. I don't know.
Yeah, so we introduced that this year. We had seen a couple other organizations kind of start doing it, like actual not-for-profit organizations that don't have anything to do with anime. And we know that people kind of like shooting stuff at each other, like running around and kind of aggression. So why not take it in a safe environment and shoot it at your friends?
So we test drove that this year, and I know our folks who are in charge of that are already looking on how to make it bigger and better. More guns, more darts, more stuff.
Boxes.
More boxes. So look forward to that next year coming up.
I think they're tired
too.
No, I'm tired.
I headed up our PR this year. We worked really hard trying to make sure we had a lot of signage up this weekend so that everyone was able to find everything, as well as trying to make sure we were constantly updating our Twitter with reminders and updates throughout the weekend. I had a great team to do that this year. I hope that helped everyone. We also did the online app. Did people appreciate that this year, or you could just go on the website?
Yes.
So, did anyone not know about the online version of the schedule? Okay, so a few of you will have to work on that.
Hi everyone, my name is Tyler Perkins. I've been with the convention for a long time. This year, I was both the secretary slash treasurer. I don't know what to say.
MVP.
I'm tired.
Graduate boss, that's what I'm saying.
Oh, is it my
Sorry, I was trying to get this conversation. My name is DJ. Wow, this is a really good microphone. My name is DJ. I am the contract manager, hotel liaison, main programming manager, one of the rave heads. Yeah, everything. What was I supposed to say? That the rock show should be bigger, it should be in main programming, so we decided to try it out this year. It looked like it did work out what we wanted. It also gave us a bigger opportunity to make both events really special. So that's why Saturday night's break was so huge, I think. And I think that's something that we're going to continue to do into the future. I don't think we really need two raves, one on Friday and one on Saturday, so that's something that we did that was different.
So I'm actually going to touch on a couple of things. So how many of you guys pre-registered your badge? Okay, how many of you purchased at con? Does anybody remember LineCon last year with us?
Yep. What about this year?
Did we have LineCon this year?
No.
Our registration staff has worked so hard on improving our systems. Tyler was involved in that as much as I just want to put a huge shout out to the people who made that program, to the people who ran registration. I think they gave you guys awesome customer service. I think I walked by 3 hours after registration opened on Friday, and we only had 7 more people in that skywalk line. And I was so impressed. I was so proud. I was going around high-fiving everyone. I was just so happy that there was not line time. The other thing I wanted to touch on, so before I was a director, I was the guest coordinator for about 3 years, and so I was able to kind of walk around and talk just to check up and see how our guests were doing. And I just kind of wanted to share some of the comments that a couple of them made. So James Marsters we had this year. And upon arrival, he was beyond words, just at the venue alone, and then just seeing the community that we have here. He was giving us high remarks of our community and how we surpass Wizards World by marks, and just because of the community that we have been able to form with you guys, because we're so close, we're always going to be there for each other. The fact that we're always so happy and we're kind. So he was really impressed with that, with you guys. As far as our voice actors, a couple of the guests that we invited this year haven't really done our kind of setting of a convention. So the fact that they were very confused, but everyone was so nice to them that, you know, they didn't get a lot of harassment. They weren't barraged a lot by convention goers, which always surprises me because I've never seen that ever. So I'm so proud of everyone. And then what was my last one? I have one more. What was my last one? What was I going to say?
Woo!
So we're to that point. Oh, and our friends from International were additionally blown beyond expectations. Like, we've had guests from Canada this year who were comparing to us what they usually witness in Canada versus the US, and how immensely different it is, and how the setting is very different. I took that as a good thing, and I'm going to continue to take it as a good thing, and I'd like to congratulate you all. I'm just congratulating you more than my staff at this point. I love my staff too.
Yeah.
This is more of a general question, but how do you guys get the guests to appear here?
Oh, hi.
We beg and plead. We tell them that we have candy and cool things.
Do you drive a van?
A lot of fun.
So the way that I've kind of been going at it is I have this master document of probably 300 names and contacts. And kind of just how it is you just reach out to them. We introduce ourselves, who we are, compliment their work and what their work means to us, what we've noticed that their work does for our community, and how we would be able to utilize what they have and how we can use it to strengthen kind of both parties. And it kind of just goes from there with negotiations and contracts. And then just by the time that they get here, it's just providing that excellent customer service, you know, blowing their minds, something with expectations, like going above and beyond the expectations. I've had guests before who have never had a liaison or are essentially plopped at a table and left alone, or will walk around a convention and not know where they're going. They don't know who any of the staff are. They don't know anything, but as soon as they come here, they see the purple shirts, or they feel confident to ask one of the attendees, where's panel room 3? And someone will take them to it, or they'll direct them nicely, or you know, they're always smiling, or they don't get harassed. So having that, and then having them bring back those good words to their friends, to their managers, and that we can kind of like grow out and include everyone. That's kind of what I have for guests. I don't know if I answered that question. What? You know, paying them, it also helps. Any questions, concerns from anyone else?
Any questions about anything?
Oh, yes.
Can you guys do a B-movie marathon next year?
Have a B-movie marathon?
What?
Okay, I should apply.
We're right there.
So when it comes to showing movies and things like that, I think you all know we have to get the viewing rights to those things.
Yeah.
But if that is something Condors want, I'm not going to be here next year, but they are going to do their best to bring that to you. So we are going to, the folks who are here today are going to remember they want a B-movie marathon.
Yeah, make those promises.
Yes. I suggest start off.
Any other questions?
Please don't feel shy.
Ooh. Oh, it's true.
I should have noticed.
I don't remember what you said.
I do, but I want Tyler to say it.
Oh, for the attendee count, that's all the people that pay to come to Daisho Con, not a warm body count. That'll be a little bit later. There's about 4,400.
That's
more than
so what he means by warm body count. So attendee count is just congoers paying for their badges. That's the number that we have for that. We also do a warm body count so that we count all of our staff, all of our volunteers, all of our awesome folks in different companies who are doing things for us, all our vendors and artists, our guests and everything like that. That usually adds to the number of how big we actually are. So that's the difference. Any other questions?
Can we have beds installed in the hallway?
Can we have what?
Beds installed in the hallway so we can take naps.
where's Aaron?
I think you'd have to beat our staff to those beds, though. Like we would probably be sleeping in those beds.
Yeah, we would definitely sleep. Roll us under a table.
What?
Let's just all get snuggies next year.
So, how many of you would purchase a Daisho snuggie?
All the staff shirts, all of us.
Can we hashtag that?
We consider all suggestions, so.
And then we did have snuggies this year, and I don't know if this meant much anymore, but Gaming Generations was selling Daisho Con shirts and hoodies and backpacks as well. So they weren't snuggies, but but they were still selling Daisho Con on behalf of us.
Okay.
Yeah, so those of you who couldn't hear her, she was suggesting we get a photo booth for folks who want to take pictures with their friends who are too shy to maybe reach out to in other ways.
There's the Sunday quietness that's felt in.
So yeah, if there's really no other questions or comments, really,
I think it's all hard with love.
What?
I'm thinking indoor racetrack.
You can suggest that to them, definitely.
They're actually real willing to listen to suggestions like that. Like, we didn't ask for any sort of drink menu, but they provided their own nerdy drink menu.
Pokemon? Did anybody have any Pokemon drinks?
Hey, I set that up.
Did you?
I did the drink menu. Yeah.
Shitty
oak.
Oh! They made a Daisho drink, which we didn't ask for. They just did.
Now listen, you guys should really request like racetracks. I've been requesting for a rocket ship for like 4 years.
I just
want
a Segway lane. Yes. So, you in the blue, you have your hand up.
Missy.
Yeah.
Missy.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, you can call me Missy, yeah.
Now that you're retired,
no.
What is the first thing you're
going to
do?
Sleep. She's going to go back to Daisho, that's what she's
going to
do.
I don't think I remember how to sleep. I don't know. This is Sunday, right?
Yeah.
I guess, you know what I'll actually do is I'll probably volunteer to help the convention next year. We have a volunteer program, and even though I'm not on staff, these people are my family, so don't make me cry. But I'm going to be back here helping them set up. Wherever they need me, whether people know me or not, we're just gonna keep running the show. So. What am I gonna do with my free time?
Finish
school. I am a college student, but okay. So when you are convention staff, if you spend a lot of time working to create the convention, and so you lose a lot of free time. And I can tell you, I have sacrificed a lot of anime watching time. To bring Daisho Con 2016 to you, so I think what I'm going to do is, the first thing when I go home and I have free time, I am going to marathon Yuri on Ice. Woo! Thank you. That is my number one thing I want to do. Thank you. Any other hangouts? Scarf, I saw you. Why are the hallways so crazy?
Yes! Cross-screen, it'll be a hit and people will probably
traumatize any condors.
It's not really trauma. It's there are just the monsters aren't glorious.
Yeah, well, we'll forward that suggestion on to our BGR staff since they couldn't be here right now.
Because they're worse.
Yeah. And then there's a giant pyramid of doom.
Yeah, that too.
Did you?
Yes. For the cosplay contest, which was awesome, I looked through the list of various anime. One that I would like to suggest for a contest, JoJo's Bizarre Adventure.
Yeah, we take any suggestions. Do you mean like for photo shoots or?
Like there was the block for judging One Piece ones, if I read it right.
Oh, no, that was actually the photo shoot schedule.
Okay, well, then for that.
Yeah.
JoJo's Bizarre Adventure photo shoot. Thank you, sorry.
Yeah, no, well, yeah, we'll take that suggestion.
Speaking of photo shoots, why don't you have a setup for just alternative people who aren't matching a set theme, like a mixed theme?
So, if for those of you who can't hear the question, why do we not have a block for like mixed theme photo shoots or for people cosplaying different things?
I can field this one. So this was something that was coordinated under PR. Staff that specifically handled all the photography concerns, and we were trying to get a really robust set of photo shoots for a bunch of different fandoms. We are definitely looking for suggestions. We're going to want to improve that for next year. I will definitely pass along to her that we're looking maybe just like a mixed theme photo shoot. Also maybe just providing some more open times for those, you know, fandoms that may not have a huge following, but there might be a group that wants to get. Yeah.
James, I saw your hand. Yeah.
Yes. I wanted to wish. I just wanted to wish the person who did the Long Live the Queen first and the best. I noticed he wasn't here, and that was really an enjoyable event that I enjoyed other years.
Yeah, keep that. Hand back there. Watching the cosplay contest where you were seated. Yes, that is something that we have always been trying to figure out how to do. And there are a couple of reasons we can't do that because. You want to explain that? I'm so technology.
I can actually talk about that. We've actually just recently started working on just getting video for the cosplay contest at all. And that's been a very. It's been a very limited setup. To be able to stream the video to another room would require a lot of additional equipment, but we can definitely take that into account for next year of setting up the video in such a way that it can be streamed perhaps to a television or a projector in the green room for cosplay contests. That's definitely something we'd like to do in the future.
Daisho Con was originally located in Stevens Point at a small Ramada hotel for anybody who was at first and second year.
And third.
And we have a piece of the property because they actually tore down the Ramada unexpectedly in the middle of our planning year, which is why we moved here. And they totally tore down the hotel, but we managed to get a brick from the hotel and we still have that brick today. The Ramada brick!
So do you want to throw out your treats?
Yeah. So again,
personally, I had a few going to touch and obviously this is how we're going to pass on. No.
I was gonna say like a couple notes for the VGR team. First off, the Overwatch competition that was really fun to participate in. So.
Oh man! Yeah. Come on down!
Tissues.
Give everybody a potato gun.
I thought she was honestly like,
I'm so sorry.
Here,
you guys,
2016.
Closing ceremonies are over. Please take your tissues, as many as you need. Don't tell me what you use with them.
Ew.
Hey, guys, we love you.
I'm really glad I recorded that.
I've never heard of this anime.
Yeah, me neither.